Hey everybody, Tom Barnes, Chicago scene at Wornstar Clothing out here in Lake of the Hills. You might ask yourself, what is Wornstar Clothing and what do they do? Well, you might want to ask bands like AC/DC, Metallica, Guns N' Roses, Led Zeppelin, because they outfit them with the clothes that they wear. You always wanted to dress like a rock star. Well, this is the place to do it. They not only outfit the bands, they also work with them for album covers, photography, custom-made clothing. All happens here with a husband and wife duo. I'm going to talk to Stefan, who is the husband of the husband and wife duo, on how this got started from a little garage and one t-shirt to a showroom out here in Lake of the Hills for the Chicago scene. So over 30 years in the music business gets you a showroom where you get to display a Led Zeppelin machine that you helped display along with the namesake of your brand, Wornstar. I'm here with Stefan. How are you, sir?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm great. So you've been in the music industry for about that long, started off playing in bands. You even got yourself on MTV back in the day with mm-hmm. your band, and you've kind of morphed your way into the clothing business, but it's a little bit more than that. But let's first talk about your career and how you got started. What was the band that got you on TV, first of all?
Well, that band was in 1989, 1990. It was called Barracuda. It was a small band. We were on a small label, did some minor touring, mm-hmm. and it was a lot of fun when I was 20 years old.
Yeah, and you know, the music business being what it is, there's always another trade that you should learn just to keep yourself busy when things are slow, and that's kind of what happened. You went to college, you got the graphic design itch, you started doing photography, and that's kind of how you fell into this business a little bit, just from all that work with the photography and the graphic design falling into because of your music industry early days of working with bands, starting to do work for them kind of on the side as little side projects for album covers and whatnot, right?
Mm-hmm. Well, yeah, I was always interested in visual arts. Always loved design and graphic design and photography. So when I was getting ready to go to college, I decided I wanted to go into the visual arts. And started just doing fine arts, getting my degree at the local community college here. And when I was switching over to Columbia College of Chicago, I decided to switch over to photography. My mother was into photography, and I kind of learned a bit from her. And I really took a love for photography back then it was still film. But I found that I was a good photographer, but I wasn't great in the dark room, but I was really good with graphic design, which was just starting to grow, with digital graphic design at that point. And so I switched my major over to graphic design, but I always loved the music industry and album artwork and album covers, and so that was really where I wanted to take my skills and start doing design in the music industry. So since then, I did a lot of album covers and band photos, guitar designs, and stuff like that.
So that's where you kind of really found your passion, where you were like, this is something I live and breathe every day. And you kind of, it's all in the family because your wife is your partner in this business venture,
yes.
And you met in high school, but as things were changing for you, you wanted to do a little side project. So you were doing that as a job, and then you're like, you know what? Like, we can offer like this very cool, unique experience for bands. You were calling like a rock and roll, not a Photoshop, but a rock and roll photography studio, mm-hmm. because your wife is a seamstress and she puts together a lot of the costumes that would help you kind of outfit a shoot for the day with certain bands.
Yes, in the 2000s, I had a photo studio. I was doing freelance photography for a lot of musicians, and my wife Sylvia was a stylist at the time, and also a seamstress. Mm-hmm. So she would curate and design clothing for some of the bands we would work with on photo shoots and on video shoots, and we got to be known as that studio that had the on-staff stylist. So we had something as far as a rock and roll studio that other people didn't have locally. We found that there was a lot of attention was being drawn to that, where people were really liking what Sylvia was doing and what she was bringing to the table. So, and we took my graphic design skills and we kind of married them together. We always like bringing visual arts and music together. So clothing just seemed like a natural next step for us. And then we started Wornstar as a side project that quickly grew into now our full-time passion.
Right, and you said you started off with like out of the garage and one t-shirt type. I mean, that's humble beginnings to now we're in a showroom and it is covered with some of the work that you've done, including the Led Zeppelin game that you helped design on the first try, by the way. Congratulations on that.
Thank you.
Among other things that artists have worn, like Eric Church platinum album up on the wall. I mean, you get notified that your artwork is being worn by certain artists and you get these awesome little accolades that you can look up on there and see the platinum artist wearing one of your t-shirt brands, which has got to be a surreal experience among the Led Zeppelin pinball game behind you.
It was really exciting when the Eric Church album The Outsiders was the first time a Wornstar item appeared on an album cover, and to have it go multi times platinum was just super exciting.
And is that something that kind of just is word of mouth in the music industry? Like when one person wears it, another band asks for it, and who got you that, and where is this from, and how does that all work for you?
It's all word of mouth. The music industry is pretty small. A lot of people know the same people. So our name gets passed around, and the clothing gets shown around, and we get orders all the time from artists we've never even spoken to, but we'll see an order come through with a name we recognize, and it's kind of like a holy crap moment.
Well, speaking of, we mentioned Eric Church and the Led Zeppelin pinball game behind you. What other bands have you worked with for people to kind of just have that either graphic design wise or shirt outfitting them with any clothing and stuff? Like, just give people an idea of some of the bands you've worked with.
Over the years, I've worked the clothing company, we work with bands like Megadeth and Five Finger Death Punch, Eric Church Band, Guns N' Roses, the list goes on and on. Outside of that, photography and graphic design, I've worked with AC/DC, Metallica, Iron Maiden, Stone Temple Pilots, that list goes on too.
Yeah, that's a pretty impressive list of bands you got there. Some of them Rock and Roll Hall of Fame members. I mean, it's gotta be a surreal experience from starting off in a garage in one t-shirt to what you have now. But what makes your clothing stand out? I know that you do custom things right in the back there with the seamstress, and how does that all work?
Well, we have a custom shop here in Lake in the Hills where my wife Sylvia designs most of the pieces, and then we have seamstresses that will help make some of those pieces. It's custom made for different rock stars and professional wrestlers all over the world, but then we also have regular customers and local artists that buy from us all the time.
Well, certainly you don't have to be in a band to wear the gear, obviously. People can come in here. You guys are open for somewhat normal business hours, I presume?
The showroom here is open from 10 to 4, Monday through Friday. We do an occasional Saturday, usually about once a month.
And for people who might be wondering, like, well, what sets this apart from other things? Like, what makes your brand and your type of clothing so unique that bands seem to like it so much?
Well, we call ourselves the Authentic Rock and Roll Clothing Company. Mm-hmm. Authentic because Sylvia and I come from the industry. We come from both sides of the clothing industry. I've been on both sides of the music industry. I've performed on stage, been in music videos, but I've also been behind the scenes doing album artwork, doing guitar design, doing pinball design, doing clothing design. So I think what stands out is for us is that we're the authentic real deal.
You really are the real deal. And just walking through the showroom and seeing the artwork on the walls from your photographs to the album covers or concert posters or what have you, you kind of get that vibe as soon as you walk in here through all the avenues that you've worked. And I think that's pretty impressive that you're doing this with your wife, your mom and dad too. You have four kids, and you've managed to do all of this by staying true to your roots here in Lake in the Hills. You didn't move, you know, like a lot of, you heard these stories a lot where, oh, they started here and then they moved to, you know, downtown Chicago or New York or LA. Like, this is not something that I think most people would find or think to find in a suburb like Lake in the Hills.
Well, I grew up in the Northwest burbs, been out here all my life. I really like it here. I love Chicago. I love going down to Chicago, but I preferred living out here. And when we had our kids and raising our kids, we wanted to stay out here. So we actually live in Crystal Lake, and we just opened the showroom here in Lake in the Hills.
What's the best way for people to learn more about your products that you sell here and hours and all that good stuff?
You can find everything on Wornstar.com.
Wornstar.com. Thank you very much, Stefan. I appreciate the time, and this store is absolutely amazing. Congratulations on what you've done here.
Thank you so much.
Absolutely. So that is the Chicago scene for today in Lake in the Hills, T-B-A-R-N-A-S at WGNTV.com. If you have a suggestion for the Chicago scene, that's T-Barnes at WGNTV.com, and you can get your fill on anything rock and roll right here, and come say hi to my friend, Stefan. He's right there. See you guys.